My name is Ron Arad, and this is my studio, and we are in Camden, in London, in England, in Europe, in the world. I came to London because of cinema and music, and it was like the tail end of the 60s. I studied architecture here and reluctantly worked for a practice. It didn't take me very long to know that I'm not cut to work for other people, especially not after lunch. So one lunchtime I didn't come back, and I made my first piece of furniture. It's the Rover chair. This is a chair, this is a sculpture of a chair. Sometimes you design things to be sold as a mass-produced things. They are designed for shops and for catalogs. Sometimes you do things that, although you can sit on them, the destination is an art gallery or a collection or a museum rather than a shop. But I'm also enjoying doing things that no one needs and that no one can afford. In my activity, I never made a difference between the different things I do, be it art, architecture, furniture design, product design. It's the same me that's doing all of them. The current things I'm working on is my favorite. And what I haven't done yet is even a better favorite. It's nice to end up with something in the evening that didn't exist in the morning. There's no formula. Sometimes you come across a new process or a new material. Sometimes you think of something in a totally different, a reversed thing. You think, what material will give me the best results? Sometimes a material looks for a function. Sometimes a function looks for a material. Currently, we are sort of up to our eyeballs with designing eyewear. I'm not a stylist. And I'm not interested in playing with retro shapes and of glasses. I'm only interested in doing things that are new. And you look at glasses and you're surprised at how same they all are, how conservative and how, you know, and you come up with an idea and you think, why didn't they do it before? Lazy people. Don't wish you were the new Philip Stark. It's a waste of time. Be, you know, what are you about? What's good about what you do? And what can you teach us that we don't understand yet?